looked at Lady Vernon and said, "Now don't tell me God didn't send this man. Let me get in a little trouble since the news is here. Y'all been racing each other." And only one of y'all gonna win. And soon as church is over, y'all go back to fighting, and let's win tomorrow. Fighting in a good way, the appropriate way. But I don't care who don't like it. I want both of y'all to come up here. I'm gonna pray for both of you. Y'all gonna finish together. Come on up here, come on, come on. Nina Turner and Shontel Brown, would y'all clap y'all hands? America, those watching all across the world. And I know both of you have pastors. Your pastor's there, and he's here. And I know Pastor Harris is your pastor, Mount Olive Church. So I'm not going to lay hands on you. I'll leave that for them. But I do want to pray for you. And I want to ask God to bless both of you after Tuesday evening. And I'm glad you both love Jesus. Now, I don't want to be all funny, but y'all look at each other and say hey to each other. Praise God. That's all I'm gonna ask right now. Praise God, amen. But both of you love Jesus. And one of you are gonna be the Congresswoman of the 11th District on Tuesday. But in the meantime, I want the blood of Jesus to cover you both. And I pray, and sometimes pastoring can be hard, but just preferentially, I'd rather be sometime a pastor than a politician, because there are so many things I know you guys have to deal with that, man, it can be what it is. But today I speak the blood of Jesus over both of you. And one of you will be our congresswoman in about 48 hours. And I speak the blood of Jesus over every decision that you make. And then I pray for your children and future children and nieces and nephews. And I thank God for both of you. And then, Father, I thank you that they have made black women look good. Thank you, Jesus. Some may disagree with one or both of their politics or their style, but what cannot be denied is they're not sitting back passively waiting on some man to give them something. And they pursued education and pursued. And Lord, today I just pray a special anointing over both of them, that you would keep them safe, God, that no fool would get access to them, God. I pray that you watch over them and cover them with the blood of Jesus, that everything they touch would turn to gold. I pray that you bless their resources, bless their mind, that you bless every decision they make, and that whoever wins would never compromise, would have the spirit of Dr. King that says a man that won't stand for something, that won't die for something, is not fit to live. And so I pray, God, that both of them have a real heart for people and for justice and for Matthew 25. I was hungry, you fed me. In prison, you came to see me. Naked, you clothed me. I pray that whoever wins would not forget that it was black people that put them in office, and that they should never forget about the same black people that took care of them, that they would be a blessing not only to blacks, but to everyone in their district. And I pray it now. In Jesus' name. Come on, y'all, clap for both of them, everybody. Do me a favor. Just for a minute, let's leave politics out of it, but just tell everybody you appreciate it.
Thank you. Thank you, God. Thank you. Thank you, Pastor Vernon. I appreciate you all. Thank you for the prayers. Thank you for the support. Thank you for the love. Thank you, Noah, for the amazing word this morning. It really lifted my spirit. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for pouring into us. And God bless you all. Thank you, Mr. Haslam, for blessing us with your presence today. And all of the wonderful leaders that have come in from out of town, Mr. Ellison, Congressman Clyburn, all of you, Pastor Early, I am so grateful, so, so grateful. And please, just keep us in your prayers. This is a battle. It's come between two dynamic women. So I just love you all. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Well, thank you, Pastor. Thank you, Council Lady. To the people of God, I was glad when they said unto me, let us come into the house of the Lord. We serve a God that's kick off your shoes good. We serve a God that is throw off your wig good. We serve a God that is unloosing your tie good. No matter what we are going through, we know that this mighty creator reigns on high. And the scripture says that he came that we might have life and have that life more abundantly. Word Church, it has been a blessing here. Pastor Vernon, Dr. Vernon, thank you for bringing two sisters up on the stage together. God bless each and every one of you. And I pray that Lord's blessings will elevate you in every aspect of your life. Amen and amen.
Bless you all. Can we clap for both of them? One of them will be our congresswoman.